Hello and welcome to this video on how to use Logos Bible software to study parallel passages in the Bible. In this video, I will show you four different resources that you can use to study parallel passages in the Bible. First, I will show you a very helpful resource for cross-references. Second, I will show you how to use Harmony or Synopsis resources from your library. And for those who have a paid version of Logos, I will also show you how to use the interactive parallel gospel reader tool. And finally, I will show you how to use the harmonies of the New Testament epistles. So let's dive into Logos. The first resource and tool that I'm going to show you is the Treasury of Scripture Knowledge, abbreviated TSK, and the Power Lookup tool. This resource is not so much about parallel passages in its technical sense, as it is about parallel ideas, whether these are words, phrases, or concepts. It's one of my most popular resources in Logos. So first of all, I will open my NIV Bible, and I drag it to the left side of the window. Next, from my library, I'm going to open the Treasury of Scripture Knowledge by typing TSK and clicking and dragging this resource to the bottom of the panel. And the last thing I will do is I will duplicate my Bible to open a second copy, and I drag that copy all the way down to the left-hand side of the TSK. Now I have my Reading Bible, I have my Treasury of Scripture Knowledge, and I have a second Bible, which is going to be my lookup Bible. So in order to work efficiently, you may want to link the TSK to your NIV, but of course you can also ignore that feature. If you want to do so, you click the three dots and you choose a link set and you apply that to both resources, the TSK and the NIV. So I select link set B for both resources, but for the second copy, I'm going to click the three dots. And instead of selecting a link set, I select the feature Send Hyperlinks Here. Now you'll see this red target icon appear in the panel, which indicates that this is the panel where all hyperlinks to biblical passages are sent to. So now you can start reading your Bible in the top panel. And as you read along, you scroll down, you see that the Treasury of Scripture Knowledge is scrolling along. And if you want to click any of the references in the TSK, then now Logos will use the Lookup Bible to present to you the reference in full context, rather than your Bible at the top. So this is in a nutshell how to use the Treasury of Scripture Knowledge resource to quickly look up cross-references as you study the Bible. But before we go to the next topic in this video, I just want to show you one more tool that is very powerful, especially when it comes to references from one resource to another resource. So let's go to the Tools menu. And in the Tools menu, we look up Power Lookup. If you don't see Power Lookup here in the top menu, you just type in the search bar Power Lookup, and there it is. So we click Power Lookup, and by default, Logos will open the Power Lookup tool on the other right-hand side of the screen, which I think is great. If you want, you can make it bigger or smaller, or you can move it around, but I like it at this place, so I'll just keep it here. So let's go to Matthew 3, verse 4, and see what the Power Lookup tool does for us. Basically, what the Power Lookup tool does is it looks at the activated resource panel. You can see that the NIV in the top here is activated because of this orange line. So it looks at this resource, and it looks for all possible references. These references are here mostly footnotes. So I see footnote C, and it refers to Matthew 3 verse 1. And that's exactly what you see in the Power Lookup tool. See Matthew 3 verse 1, and the whole verse is written out for you. The next reference that we see is footnote D, which is a reference to 2 Kings 1 verse 8. And instead of clicking the footnote and then hovering over 2 Kings 1, 8, or clicking it so that the Lookup Bible will show you that verse, the Lookup tool makes it much easier. So it recognizes footnote D, it sees the reference to 2 Kings 1, verse 8, and it writes it all out for you. The same for E, reference to Leviticus, etc., etc. And when we come to the references under the heading above verse 13, we see lots of references here. They are also written out, 3:13, but it is all the way down here. Matthew 3, verse 13 to 17, Mark 1, verse 9 through 11, Luke 3, verse 21 and 22. So the Power Lookup tool enables you to glimpse over, to skim read all the references that are given in the text. Now it does the same with the Treasury of Scripture Knowledge, which is a resource full of references, but there are just too many. So the Power Lookup tool, you see there's a whole list of references, and these are references that Logos is finding in this panel. So that's not very helpful to see them all in one at one time. But what you can do is you can select a number of references, and then the Power Lookup tool will display only those references that are part of that selection. So far about the cross references and the Power Lookup tool. Let's now have a look at the Synopsis resources and the harmonies of the Gospels. Many stories about Jesus' ministry are told in more than one Gospel, thus giving us different perspectives on the same or a similar event. As you study such an event, it is helpful to compare the passage to the parallel passages from the other Gospel writers. So one way of comparing passages is by opening up any of your Synopsis or Harmony resources from your library. So let's go to the library. And we will filter for our Harmony resources by typing type, colon, and then Bible Harmony between quotes. This gives you a list of all the Harmony resources and Synopsis resources that you currently own in your library. It doesn't really matter which of these Synopsis or Harmonies of the Gospels you use, but for this video we will select the Synopsis of the Four Gospels by Kurt Aland. When you go to the upper left corner, you can click the hamburger menu icon, and that will open up the table of contents. Now, as you see in the table of contents, all events in the Gospels will be organized in a somewhat chronological order. So it starts with the prologue and it ends with the resurrection. So looking at the prologue, you will see that each Gospel has a prologue, and you can compare them together. The promise of the birth of John the Baptist is only described in the Gospel of Luke, so you won't see the other Gospels here. But as you go to the genealogy of Jesus, we'll find one in Matthew and in Luke. And if we go to John the Baptist, we see this passage in all the Gospels. So the nice thing about this resource is that you can go to the top here and select any of the Bible versions you want to use. The passages will be the same, but then in a different translation, of course. And if you master the Greek language of the New Testament, you can even select the Greek New Testament in any of your editions, and you can compare how literal the parallels are or not. This enables you to quickly compare the Greek text of the parallel passages, which can be used to study the interdependence relationships between the Gospels. And of course, instead of browsing through the events of the Gospel, you can also type in any reference in the reference box, and that will take you to the relevant passage. So the Harmony or Synopsis resources in Logos are very useful to compare parallel passages in the Gospels. But if you have a paid version of Logos 10, whether it is a starter package or higher, then there is an even better tool in Logos to study the parallel passages of the Gospels. It's called the Parallel Gospel Reader tool. And you can find it either in your library or in the Tools menu, where you type Parallel and the Parallel Gospel Reader will show up. And once you have opened the Parallel Gospel Reader, the first thing you want to do is to select any of the Harmony or Synopsis resources in your library. And these are actually the same resources that we saw just a minute ago. And it doesn't really matter which of the resources you choose, but I'm used to a Synopsis of the Four Gospels by Kurt Aland, so I'll click this one. So again, you see all the events in the Gospels organized by a more or less chronological order. And each event has a little triangle followed by a description of the event or a passage heading. And if you click that, the section will expand to show you the passage in all available Gospels. that contain the passage. Now pay attention to what makes this parallel gospel reader really powerful as compared to the static harmony or synopsis resources in your library. If you go to the top right, you click the button View, and it allows you to select which gospels you want to compare together. You can display all four gospels, or you can limit the comparison to the synoptic gospels. Or if you just want to study the relationship between Mark and Matthew, you just select Matthew and Mark. But for now, I'll enable all of them. And when you look at sort, then that allows you to sort the scrolling order by gospel. So if you click on Luke, then you see a gray bar here above Luke, and all the events will be sorted in the order that they appear in the Gospel of Luke. Let's go for the default view for now. And let's go back to the call of the disciples to see one very powerful feature of this parallel gospel reader. As you hover over any of the words in any of the parallel passages, Logos is highlighting the parallel wording, the equivalent in the other gospels. So here, for example, you see immediately, which is a word that occurs in Matthew 4 and in Mark 1, but not in Luke and John. We see, follow me and I will make you become fishers of men. Now, the same phrase, fishers of men, is used in Matthew and in Mark, but in Luke it's called, you'll be catching men. And another feature is that if you right click on any of the words, you can do many of the searches that are normally available in when you read the Bible. And again, if you master the Greek New Testament, you can select the Greek text and compare all the passages to see how literal the parallels are to each other. All right, that's it for the parallel gospel reader. Let's now go to the last section of this video. So let's now go to the last section of our video, which is on parallel passages in the epistles. When we go back to our library and we type again, type colon quotation marks Bible harmony, we see that there are many more harmonies. For example, there's a harmony on Samuel, Kings, and Chronicles, because they have several passages that are parallel to each other. There are a harmony of the Gospels. There is a harmony on Jude and 2 Peter. There are parallel passages in the pastoral epistles and in the Pauline letters. So let's just quickly have a look at how these work. And by the way, if you don't own these resources yet, you'll find a link to those resources in the description below this video. So let's open the parallel passages in the pastoral epistles. So let's make it a little bigger. So like the other resources, if you click the hamburger menu icon in the top left corner, that will open or close the table of contents. And here you see that all passages are organized by their occurrence in the epistles. And if you go back to the library and you open the parallel passages in the Pauline letters, they are very similar, but the way that the passages are arranged is slightly different. So if you go to the first topic, you will see that it is taken from, well, Paul's conversion, Acts, and then the gospel proclamation, it's taken from Romans, and then greeting is also from Romans, encouragement, Romans, and it compares the passage to similar passages in the other Pauline epistles. And it looks like the term Pauline epistles is defined conservatively. In this video, I showed you several ways to study parallel passages in the New Testament, mainly focusing on the Gospels, but also touching on the epistles in the New Testament. And as you saw, Logos also offers harmony or synopsis resources for other books in the Bible, like Samuel and Kings and Chronicles and Jude and Peter. And again, links to those resources can be found in the description below this video. I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you did so, please like the video and subscribe to my channel, so we can get these videos out to a larger audience. And as a bonus, I invite you to see my list of recommended books at www.logos.com/PAUW. Please note that any purchases through this webpage will not only enrich your own library, but will also support my work of Bible translation in Papua New Guinea through a small commission at no additional cost to you. And if you made it all the way to the end, I reward your attention with an exclusive partner offer for Logos 10. Check out the link in the description below to get a unique discount on any Logos 10 base package, plus get 5 free books from a selected list of resources. All right, enjoy and see you next time.